Welcome back to Let's Play Baldur's Gate. Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari, starting out here in Candlekeep. Well, that looks horrible. No, maybe we do want it smoothed out.
Such menial tasks.
I don't know, what do you guys think? It's really blocky when you move, when you zoom in like that. Don't want outlines, definitely not. Slightly softer, slightly out of focus look. Well, this look better, right? What do you guys think? I mean, I'm not always going to be zooming in that much. This seems to be the sweet spot somewhere around here. This will zoom out to look. Now, this is me, Sapphire. Yes, and I have 4 plus 2. Because I gave myself a, in this case would be a constitution bonus of +2 hit points per level. This, for a wizard, is really tough, especially in the beginning levels. From what I read, these bonuses only take place for the first 10 levels. So after that, it's not going to really make much of a difference. And constitution helps with certain saves as well, so. The Candlekeep Inn. So if you hit tab, you get to see interactables in the area. These guys are like basically tutorial people.
Hello, child. Shall we continue your lessons?
I've been instructed to tell you about the basic mechanics of movement and time. If there's anything in that sort you would know more of. I can't see reading all this, but by default I'm going to be reading everything, guys, but... The clock button... at the menu bar. Area map. This we know. Kind of breaking the fourth wall, or breaking character for him to talk about. Was he saying touch screens or touchpad? Bad pathing not mentioned. Alright. I haven't selected when to pause everything. I'm gonna have a lot of pausing, and I'm probably going to, as time goes on, slowly take out the pauses. I know it irritates some people. I think it's down here. Select all. Party AI on. That's another way of doing it. Quick loot. Talk. I don't have special abilities. It might be here. Oh, that's camp.
I should have joined the army.
He doesn't like that. Really, Sapphire, must you sleep out in the open? And please go see Winthrop in the inn if you need a place to rest. Yeah, I didn't mean to do that. Quick save. Alright, let's pause the clock. This must be what I'm looking for. Options. Auto pause menu. Okay, here we go. This is what I wanted. Center on party member. When triggering an auto pause. Character hit. Whenever a party member is hit, that's going to happen very often. Character injured. Yes. Character death. Yes. Character attacked. Character's target destroyed. Sure. Weapon unusable. Or end of round. I'll leave that out. Enemy sighted. Yep. Spell cast. Trap found. I will go like this. The keys, I'm pretty sure I'm going to keep the same. Page actions, miscellaneous. Yeah, pretty much. Character arbitration. Alright. So then here, already in game, area map, oh, priest quarters, temple of Agma, the storehouse, clinic, bunkhouse, barracks, and here's Candlekeep itself. Oh my. Destination unreachable, because we haven't explored enough yet. Area map, background. Oh, that looks horrible. Journal. Garion, my foster father, has informed me that we must immediately leave Candlekeep and set out on a journey. He has given me some gold, 50 gold pieces, and I must purchase supplies for the road, including weapons and armor. I cannot wear armor, I'm a mage, but you know what. User? I don't know what that means. Done quests or none? Is this? Wait. I guess just to get out, yeah, click on there. Inventory. So I have a quarter staff of 1d6. My armor class is 10. Dexterity? Dexterity is minus 3. I guess that affects my... Am I effectively armor class 7? After dexterity minus 3? So yeah, 50 gold. Kit description. Yep. Here's your mage. Information. Biography. So I can't add to this. Alright. Inspired by your foster father's knowledge of the magical arts, you have made especially productive use of your library home. You have pored over the vast, if often inaccessible, treasury of magical lore and learned as much as you can. Garion has been kind enough to instruct you in the basics, but he seems a touch overly concerned about your safety. You know, however, that experience could teach you so much more, and you yearn to travel as a journeyman mage. You know little of how you came to be a ward of Garion's, but over the years you have gleaned something of your mother's tale, from his vague allusions and from the words he sometimes uttered in tear-filled sleep. She was an elf from the High Forest, and a friend of his for many seasons. As you have no memory of her, nor any keepsakes to remind you of her existence, you have come to believe that she died while giving birth to you. Perhaps it was the pain of such a parting that led Garion to cloister himself within the narrow halls of Candlekeep and raise you as his own. Of your father you have learned nothing. So it might be because I changed the UI here, but I thought in the actual, you know, you could add to your biography. So I will just say this. My character is a big-time book fanatic. She loves books. She loves reading. She collects. She loves collecting books. So where there is books, she'll really want to pick them up. So maybe sometimes when there are other more useful things that can be purchased, she'll want a book or two, or three, or four. My character is very curious, nosy, curiosity kills the cat type thing, Hopefully not too often, anyway. And basically that's what she has done all this time in Candlekeep, is reading on everything, trying to gain as much as experience as she possibly can, or knowledge, rather, of the world outside Candlekeep, being she really has not departed Candlekeep all her life. So it's basically her way of escaping and learning about the world, which she's always wanted to do, and never really able to. And not only that, but learning magic and the secrets of the arcane. So those are her, some of her basic traits. She also has, for whatever reason, a great fear of snakes. And she had a bad experience with a common variety snake, nothing monstrous, when she was a child. So is instilled in her a fear of snakes or anything snake-like. Lizards are fine. Once you take the feet away, yeah, unless it's a tiny little garter snake, she's afraid of it. So information gives us customize. Oh, I can add here. Well, stand by, guys. Okay, so I've written it up. I think I've included everything. Sapphire has a great curiosity of the world outside of Candlekeep. She is actually quite curious and nosy in general, which tends to get her in trouble. She spent her life within these walls, thus much of her knowledge of the lands beyond has been gleaned from books. She's an avid book reader and collector of books, to the point where it seems she'd carry a library on her back if she could. After having read quite a bit about the arcane art, she's managed to learn a spell or two. Due to an unfortunate incident with a common snake when she was younger, Sapphire has a great fear of snakes. Sapphire is a generally kind person, yet also a free thinker. Laws and rules don't impress her very much. She tends to view people on an even footing until she gets to know them. It should come as no surprise that she tends to not judge a book by its cover. Script. Yeah. So the colors are added in that sound, yeah. We can change that any time, that's neat. There she is, done. Okay. Mage book. So we have magic missile memorized. And known is sleep and magic missile. Three skulls, yeah, does not apply. Return to game. Alright, you guys are probably getting impatient for me to just do stuff already. Let's talk to Phlydia.
Hello there.
So I might change the sounds as we go because I'm not sure how it coincides with my voice. I want it to be loud enough to be heard, but not to have them speaking over me to where I can't be heard. Oh, hello. Hey, have you seen my copy of the History of Halorua anywhere? You know, I can't stand the constant shuffling of arthritic feet and up in the library, so I thought I'd get a bit of fresh air just east of here and... Oh, I hate being so absent-minded. Please, if you find it, I really do need it back. Alright, journal updated. Dear absent-minded Phlydia has lost another of her books. Another one, huh? The History of Halorua this time. Last time she was at Candlekeep, she lost an entire four-volume set in the hay we keep for the cows.
Hello there.
No luck, huh? Did I go visit the cows this time? Oh, I can never remember. Alright, so another tutor here.
Hello. Shall we continue your lessons?
I'm here to tell you about the circles of the grounds around everyone's feet. Is there a color you'd like explained? Okay, a blue circle is neither friendly nor hostile. You can freely initiate dialogue by seeking them. Green. Party member, a creature you have summoned. Red, I know, is danger, enemy. Charmed. Okay, the circle turns red. I remember that happening. Yellow. Character out of control. Morale failure. When some characters become enraged. Purple. Character's feet around your character see that inaccessible. A cutscene or similar event. I know all I need to know about feet, thanks. The aura surrounding them is important. Okay. So blue is friendly. Looks more like a turquoise or aquamarine. Cows. Moo cows. Another tutor.
Hello, child. Shall we continue your lessons?
Inventory. Well, pretty self-explanatory. Plus symbol appears on the corner of your character's portrait. I mean there. Alright. Well, let's go into the Candlekeep Inn. Take a look around. More tutors.
Fine.
Hello, child. Shall we continue your lessons?
Negotiating with merchants, innkeepers, tavern owners, and the like. If you guys want to read this, you can pause. I'm not going to read all this stuff. Pretty self-explanatory, like I said. Renting a room. When you're in town, you won't be able to sleep in the street. We did that by mistake. Beginning of the episode. Was it last episode? I think it was beginning of this episode. Instead, find an inn with rooms available. Boom, boom, boom. Rumors! Choose the beverage of your choice in the list, select buy, and listen. Not everyone will say something worth hearing, but occasionally you might hear some tidbit that will turn into a quest you can complete. And this guy?
Hello, child.
Advanced principles
your lessons?
Of movement. How do we use stairs? Click on them. Opening doors. Traveling between areas on the world map. Best to go to the edge of where you are. Quick loot system. Red diamond button on the left side of the screen. Bottom action bar. Firebead Elvenhair.
It's hard to find decent folk nowadays.
Ah, yes, I'm back within the hallowed halls of Candlekeep. With this iron crisis upon us, the trip from Baragos was more hazardous than I care to relate. You're Gryon's ward, aren't you? My, you have come into your own, if you would permit an old man jealous of youth to say so. I left an identifier scroll with Tethryl in the inner grounds. He should be done examining it by now, so if you could fetch it for me, I'd be grateful. Or we could keep it. Decisions.
It's hard to find decent folk nowadays.
I have not spoken with Tethryl yet. Alright. Ready for this? One of the most iconic phrases in the game. Coming up.
My hotel's as clean as an elven arse.
Well, hello there, young one. Come to visit your old pal Winthrop, have you? Well, don't forget the 10,000 gold piece book entrance fee, as per candle keeps custom, don't you know? You always were the big kidder, Winthrop. That gets funnier very nearly every time I hear it. Well, perhaps not quite so often. Haw, just having a bit of fun with you, my friend. Them monks may be walking around with poles in their nethers, but you know you are always welcome here in my sight. Gryon did well by you, he did. So, is there anything I can do for you? Some drinks? A room to sleep? Or anything to buy? What do you have? Alright, so... Got any slings? 1 gold. Well, I do want a sling. Bullets, 1 for 20. I don't think it can get any lower than that, but I do want to check around. How about some fire wine? Hear any rumors that there might be going on? I don't get rumors for that. Am I supposed to do anything here? Huh? Will the rumors just automatically show up?
My hotel's as clean as an elven arse.
It's good to see you again as any other I could have laid eyes on. Make yourself as comfortable as you will. If you wish for anything, just ask. Yeah, I might need to drink something more expensive to get rumors, and I don't have the money for that. Linda!
Pleased to make your acquaintance.
At last, I am in Candlekeep, where I've wanted to be for so long, but now I wander the rooms here, moody and sad. You look very pale indeed. Aren't you feeling well? I had a terrible adventure. For me, as well as for the man I love. That sounds horrible. Do you want to talk about it? You're Gryon's foster child, aren't you? Yes, I think I want to talk to you about it. Have you been to the infirmary? My fiancé is recovering there from the injuries he got in his last fight. No, I haven't spoken to him yet. I don't know where infirmary is. I suppose my character does. He has an obvious injury. He lost an arm, but the wounds that are still troubling him are his memories of what happened during this fight, and the conditions under which he lost that arm. I am troubled by it too. You see, I cut off his arm. It was the only thing to do. Courting ritual. I beg your pardon. That I don't understand. We were on our way to Candlekeep when suddenly a portal started opening near us. Monsters came out and started attacking. It was horrible. Sir Trun defended us, and it looked as if he would win easily. Then one of the creatures bit into his arm, dragging him toward the portal. He lost his sword. There was only one possible way to save him, and I used it. Otherwise he would be dead by now. That is horrible. So what now? I don't know. Maybe it will all resolve by itself. No, it's not that easy. Sir Trun proposed to me, what seems a long, long time ago, and we went on this educational journey to Candlekeep. You have to understand, I'm the daughter of a noble family that never touched any kind of weapon. His gaze upon me when he realized what happened. Forgive me, but I do not want to talk more about it. I need to be patient and hope he will overcome his feelings. Poor Sir Trun. He is so brave. He grimly tries not to attribute any importance to the matter. But he doesn't succeed in overcoming his feelings of horror. He is bound to his proposal to a woman he now fears, and is trying to convince himself it is nothing to worry about. I still see that look in his eyes. I decide not to go to the infirmary until someone brings the news of his recovery, or until he approaches me himself.
Pleased to make your acquaintance.
Alright, so Firebead Elvenhair, an old mage who makes the occasional visit here from Baragos, has left an identify scroll with Testeril in the inner grounds. I swear without me to run its endless errands, the keep would crumble into the very dust in which it sprung. I met Linda in the Candlekeep Inn. She is the fiancée of Sir Trun, who is recovering from his wounds in the Candlekeep Infirmary. They had a traumatic encounter and haven't talked since. Okay. Well, she's here, so I can't really break into that, can I? Thurston?
No time to chit-chat.
Step up to the heat, young one. You'll need a good fire to warm the chill stares of those monks. Most inhospitable they are. Isn't it so, Levy? The noblewoman says, oh yes, darling, they are most standoffish. There's definitely something behind saying, well, that dialogue choice. I hit something by mistake. Well, at least the monks were quiet in their condemnation. Indeed, Levy. You have lived here, Sapphire, but from your tone, I wager you have forgotten much of the tact they should have taught. Leave us, please.
No time to chit-chat.
I think you should be going before you end up scaring the missus.
A pleasure to meet a socially acceptable person such as yourself.
Yet her words here say something else. I'd much prefer if you would leave me be. Now, what's in here? Pretty sure we can just take whatever we want from here. It's just a dagger. Sure, I'll take a dagger. Let's go upstairs.
A simple matter.
Nice and quiet up here. This guy's sleeping. Pretty sure you can't wake the sleeping people. No. 4 gold. We need this for our journey. Garion has not given us nearly enough. No one in here? You can try to force. Oh. Successful. A silver necklace. Don't mind if I do. Now this one, I believe, if I remember right, there's one up here that you can only disarm if you're really, really good at picking locks. And I'm not. Christian.
Don't touch me. I might catch something.
Yes, might I help you? I was just wondering who else was sharing the inn with me tonight. Who might you be? I might very well be anyone, but I am Christian of Waterdeep. Likely you would not know my family name or history, and this suits me well and good. These trips to Candlekeep are a bit of extravagance on my part, and while I neither use illicit substances nor consort with hired company, I spend quite enough here that I should not like it common knowledge. To this end, I would appreciate it if you would forgo your odd little attempt at introductions and leave me to my thoughts.
Don't touch me! I might catch something.
You once again? I should appreciate if you would remove your company until I sought it. Good day. Well. Fail. Let's try a few times. I know there's probably a key combination I can hit just so I don't have to go scrolling down, but... yeah, we're not getting into that one. Quincy.
Away with you, beggar.
What? I certainly hope there's an explanation for this intrusion. Explain yourself. Just getting to know the neighbors? Who might you be? My name is Quincy. Beyond that is my own business and none of your concern. Leave, lest I report this intrusion to the guard. All right, then.
Such menial tasks. Such menial tasks.
I am not renting a room just yet. Menial tasks, indeed. Oh, another tutor. Oh, and a barrel of something. Ooh. Who just throws 8 gold in a barrel like that?
Hello, child. Shall we continue your lessons?
Cleric's ability to turn undead. Useful for whenever we have a cleric. Clerics or paladin. Clerics and paladins can use their holy symbols to repel undead creatures. To use this ability, select the turn undead button. If the level is high enough, any undead creature in your field of view will flee while this ability is active. You might even destroy some weaker undead outright. That's awesome when that happens. Warrior ability to guard. Paladin, fighter, or ranger. Defend a character in area by selecting the guard button in the character's spot you wish to defend. The character attacks any creature that approaches a specified area or attacks the protected character. Any creature that attacks it. Yeah, it's kind of weird the way that was written. The bard song. I don't know if I'm going to have a bard. I'm not crazy about bards. Bards can sing a song that removes all fear from their entire party, setting each party's member's morale to its highest level. No party member will ever flee in panic. That's pretty good. Pretty useful. While singing, a bard can do nothing else but move. Shaman's Dance. Oh, this must have been added for Enhanced Edition. Select the dance button. While the ability is active, shamans cannot move or take any other action. It will summon a steady stream of helpful spirits to aid in battle. Not similar to a bard. Spirits act of their own accord. The summoner does not direct them, but they are clever enough to differentiate friend from foe. Oh, that's interesting. What is this? The barracks. Alright. Been running for quite a while. Stay tuned for the next episode when we check out the barracks. Until then, always seek adventure.